what we're about to do is demonstrate in detail of exactly what ports to use when assembling the spill stop, specifically the actuator. I have a lot of characteristics of this that we can easily make a mistake, but this video is to demonstrate exactly what needs to be done. The actuator has 5 ports that are threaded. We are going to use three ports only. Number 3, which is located here. Number 2, and number 4. Each one has a specific function, and I will explain as I go. How we install it, we first install number 3. And this goes in a snug fit. Do not over tighten. Second, we put it in number 2. Again, snug and do not over tighten. The material of the actuator is a soft cast metal that can easily strip. We follow by the third and final and port number 4. Now, once those are assembled, we can now put the regulator assembly on top. And I'm going to demonstrate the ports and their functions. We now install the vinyl tubing in connection to port number 3. And this will give you the direction or flow that the actuator needs in order to operate the operated diaphragm pump. And it goes directly like that. It's a push connection. Okay, next, we're going to install the vinyl hose that the airflow, once the regulator is activated, will streamline the airflow into the valve and direct it into the port number 2. Once the quarter inch vinyl tubing is connected to port number 2, you can then attach the other end of the 8-foot vinyl tube supplied by Blacoh to the normally closed shutoff valve that is directly mounted on the air inlet of the pump. What this will allow to do, once you instigate the airflow, you increase pressure by using the regulator assembly attached to the spill stop, which increases the pressure to open the valve and allow airflow to the pump. Once a diaphragm failure happens, the vessel will fill up with your process fluid, rise the float ball, redirect the piston inside the actuator valve, and will bleed out the port number 4. This can be hooked up into a variety of different applications, whether you want it on a skateboard or electrical panel, or we have a whistle that's available as well. But that's how we hook up the actuator valve to assemble it.